Hello, this video is combining how do I use the distributive property and combining like terms all together to solve an equation. How do I use both of those skills to help me out? And we're gonna do one example, and it looks a little scary when you first look at it because there are a lot of pieces. We have negative 2x plus 5 times x minus 6 all equals 6. Now I'm gonna split my equation down by equal sign. And our entire purpose for solving an equation is to get x all by itself. Well, we have a couple issues here. The first issue is that there are two different x's. We can't have that. We gotta get those x's together somehow. Another issue that we have are these parentheses. We also can't have those parentheses. We gotta get rid of those. So we have to decide which one are we gonna do first. Well, order of operations tells me that I'm always gonna do multiplication before I do addition, which means I have to do my distributive property before I do combining like terms. So my distributive property tells me I can take this 5 and multiply it into my parentheses. So I can go 5 times x to get 5x, and 5 times negative 6 to get negative 30. And then the negative 2x is just gonna come straight down, so is the plus sign, and the 6 is still gonna equal 6. Now that I'm done with those parentheses, I use my distributive property to get rid of those. I can use my combining like terms to put these two x's into just one x. So negative 2 plus 5 gives me 3x. And the negative 30 comes down and the 6 comes down. Now that I don't have any parentheses anymore, and I took my two x's and I combined them together to only make one x, now I can use my inverse operations to get x by itself. And I'm going to start with my number that's furthest away from my x. Furthest away from my x is the minus 30. So the inverse of minus 30 would be plus 30. And I need to do that to both sides of my equation. Cancels out. Bring my 3x down. 6 plus 30 is 36. And lastly, 3 times x, the inverse would be divide. So I'm going to divide by 3 on each side. That cancels out, and I find that x equals 12. I've isolated my variable, and I have an answer. But before I move on, I need to check my work to make sure that I'm correct and I didn't make any silly little mistakes. So I need to take the original problem and rewrite it. So negative 2x plus 5 times x minus 6 all equals 6. And what I'm checking is that if I take the answer I got, x equals 12, and put the 12 where both x's are in the original problem, calculate that out, does it still equal 6? So let's do that. Remember, everything else stays exactly the same. The only thing that changes is we're putting the number 12 where our variables were. And it's kind of weird, but we're gonna have some double parentheses going on. And I accidentally crossed over my line there. So I need to make sure, if I calculate everything, all of this, does it still make 6? And I could type that in my calculator, or I could use order of operations, which is what I'm going to do. So if I go negative 2 times 12, that gives me negative 24. I'm just gonna bring this plus 5 down because I'm gonna calculate this part. What's 12 minus 6? Well, that's 6. And now I'm gonna continue with my order of operations. 5 times 6 gives me 30. Bring my negative 24 down. Now, does negative 24 plus 30 make 6? Yes, it does. 6 does equal 6. That's how I know I'm correct. So if we go back to the original purpose of this video, the video was to help us use our distributive property and use combining like terms to help us solve an equation, which we did, and we got x equals 12.